They tick everything, you know. And you know they know what they are ticking. And sometimes they add a few more things that we don't know about. Because they have been involved in so many of these things. And there was this guy who was a tanki, a medium. And the Lord delivered him. There were a lot of weird things that happened when they did the deliverance. And after we finished with that, he was delivered and he was moving in the Lord. He came out from prison. And a few years later, he's back in prison, unfortunately, because, you know, the Lord gives us free will. And so whenever I look at this, sometimes you see a wince in my face because I think of him and I pray for him. Because not only is he in prison, his wife is in prison, his daughter is following in his footsteps in that kind of style. And it pains our hearts, but we keep praying. So when you see this, use this as a prayer for the kingdom of God to come in individuals' lives. You might know some people. So we think about different people that we know of, and we pray for them. And then for God's kingdom to come in all these areas, whenever God's people do good things, God's kingdoms come. It covers also conservation, protection, care of creation. In about 2 weeks' time, yesterday in the newspaper you might have seen, there's a worldwide conference held in Singapore, will be held in Singapore in 2 weeks' time, called Asia for Animals. Well, I've taken leave and I will be there. Okay, and I'm going to put our brochures on God and animals there. And you know the one that says, when your pet dies? I'm going to put it there so that they know that the Christian church is also committed to caring for creation and not just for humans alone. Because that's the heartbeat of God too. See the big picture. It covers the whole of creation, not just us. There will be two theme songs for this year. This one is very famous. I think the younger ones would know this one. You actually have a dance. I think Maverick did a dance on this. You can remember it, okay? Surely children are not made for the streets. When you think of this, you think of the slum areas like in Cambodia. Fathers were not made to leave. Surely this isn't how it should be. Let your kingdom come. Surely nations were not made for war. Broken were not meant to be ignored. This can't be what you saw. Let your kingdom come here in my heart. And then the prayer, I will carry out your compassion to love a world that's broken, to be your hands and feet. I will give with the life that I have been given to move beyond religion, to see the world be changed by the power of your name. I can see a bit of that happening when we reach out to the residents in Dover with the carnival and with the fun fair. I pray that there will be more. Life isn't made to regret. The loss were not made to forget. Surely faith without action is dead. Let your kingdom come. Lord, break this heart. I think we see this picture quite often in daily life. And one of the challenges I want to make to you, in Chinese New Year coming up, you all give ang pao, but we give ang pao to our friends. What I would like to suggest for you to do is to set aside some money, not your tithe, but extra, okay, and go and buy NTUC vouchers, $10 ones. And then when you go to Little India or Chinatown or Topayo, certain parts of it, as the Lord leads, ask him to show you who to give it to. And the person might be really in need. And just give it out quietly. It will bless them. It might give them hope. It might not be the $10. It might be you don't have an NTUC voucher. You got $50 in your pocket and the Lord says, this is my money. Give. Just give. And you can see what the Lord can do. You don't have to preach. You can say, God bless you. Or you can offer to pray for the person. I'm not asking you to do things that I don't do, okay? I'm asking you to actually be the church. Don't just talk church, worship in church, but be the church when you go out. Because the Lord will make a difference to your life. And then it says, the Lord's name is a shelter for the hurting, for the weak, the undeserving. Your name holds everything I need. The other song will be, I Will Speak Out, for those who have no voices. Some of this we'll be singing today and the next few weeks. I will stand up for the rights of the oppressed. I will speak truth and justice. I will defend the poor and the needy. I will lift up the weak in Jesus' name. I will speak for those who have no choices. Cry out for those who live without love. Show God's compassion to the crushed and broken in spirit. I will lift up the weak in Jesus' name. How to apply? How do we apply thy kingdom come? Seek first the will of God in our lives. You know, sometimes we think that everything, the Methodist Church is well known for democracy, yeah? Everything vote, vote, vote. But you know, democracy is not of the Lord. If you look at the Bible, what happens? When people started voting in the Bible, they voted for Barabbas instead of Jesus. In the Old Testament, they voted for King Saul instead of whatever Samuel, whom God had anointed. So we've got to know that at least in our own lives, we don't say, God, let's vote on it and see whether you got one vote, I got one vote, and then I can vote out with God. We are talking about the kingdom of God, where God is king. Sign a blank check for God to fill in each day. And then live it out. It's not a matter of Sunday, you know, I love God, I worship God, and then Monday to Saturday we worship another God, money. And I can tell you, in Singapore, money is the idol. You talk about the false god in Singapore, the main one that everybody kowtow to, the government, the business, the church sometimes, it is money. When we make our policies, money is so important. What if we don't have? Is this okay? What does the government say? How do they practice elsewhere? The church is supposed to lead the world in values. We need to hear the Lord on how we use money. He comes first. And then hold on in hope, because there are times when you feel you can move forward in the Lord, but sometimes you don't see the light breaking through. Hold on until light breaks. God is working his purpose out, and his kingdom will come in fullness one day. What have we said so far? Kingdom of God is where God is king. It covers everything. It has come and is coming. It is the will of God, not necessarily my will. It is joyous. It's not the circumstance. We can discover it when we know his heart. It is for our best and is revealed in stages. It covers the whole of life. And the application for us today is to give our lives back to him as a blank check. Even as we continue the service, I'm going to ask you to tell the Lord, this year, my life is yours. Let us pray. Lord, you are King. Lord, would you give us hearts of flesh instead of hearts of stone, that we might be your people in your world. Give us this commitment, this seriousness this year, not just to talk about things or to sing about things, but to let you be the Lord of our lives, the King of our lives. Let us be your hands and feet in your world, and let your kingdom come through us. In the name of Christ, amen. Invite the ushers to come forward. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for everything that you've given us, and Lord, right now we ask that you will receive these gifts for the extension of your kingdom on earth. In the name of Christ, amen.